EA Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to the home of the Ravens, sold-out M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore, Maryland. Coming up, it's divisional round Saturday, and we've got an AFC battle on tap between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Baltimore Ravens.
For Jacksonville.
The first of four berths in the conference championships on the line here as divisional weekend in the NFL is underway. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Left side, Andrews with it complete. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. They'll contain him to just four, second down.
At the 29-yard line.
Across the 30 to the 31-yard line.
Quarterback on the
He'll get two on the keeper, but it becomes now a third down.
A gain of two on the play. Brings up third and four.
Play action fake. They'll look to throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Andrews. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That third down conversion good for 23. So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 45-yard line. First carry for the former Buckeye, J.K. Dobbins. And a good burst there right from the start as he'll get this one out near the 35. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
Baltimore, first down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
Check 50, check 50.
Hiking 18, 19 tight, go!
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Being chased out left. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. I guess no need to force it when you can do that instead. First down, 18-yard gain.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
60 Bison.
Check, check.
Here's Dobbins. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. They've taken this opening kickoff and marched it right down the field defensively. Not much resistance.
And that's the point, because my admiration is for the guys moving the ball right now. They know what they're doing. Their plan is working. But I flip it over and watch and say, okay, what are you going to do to change things up? Because if you don't, they're going to put that ball in the end zone real soon.
And perhaps now close to the first points of this divisional round game as it's first and goal. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. It's their quarterback. A three-yard run as he kept it himself. And the Ravens take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. And the Ravens lead at 7-0.
Makes the score, Ravens 7, Jaguars nothing. Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Going to call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. At the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Side, a completion to his tight end, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
A gain of 14.
Give him 14 on that one, and a first down. They'll look to throw. And connecting here with DJ Shark. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. His first catch of the divisional round goes for a first down. He had 5 catches last week in their wild card win. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10, a very chilly day here, but no snow. And I got to say, if it's going to be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with 3rd and 11.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though, huh?
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Hey, it kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
Number 28, Mike Martin's coming. He's coming. Check in.
Third down, he'll drop to throw. Fine work by the Baltimore defense to help bring up fourth down.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they're able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker rule that they can fall back on anymore.
So on fourth down, Jags kicker Josh Lambeau comes on. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And that is no good. And this score will stay right where it is. These playoff games have a tendency to be tight. You have to wonder if that missed field goal could haunt him later.
Yeah, we're always looking for the key plays, right? The ones that we're going to magnify. Usually those happen in the second half or later in the game. This might be the key play of the game showing up here in the first half.
I got 15. Pioneer.
They go play action here on first down. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll get this way down into Jacksonville territory. A big play that time for the Ravens. 45 yards. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. From the shotgun. He'll look to throw. Manning with the left side is Brown. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of five.
A gain of five brings up second and goal at the four-yard line.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. It's their quarterback with his second touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Ravens will add on to their lead. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead.
Ravens 14, Jaguars nothing. Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Now this will make it into the end zone. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
At their own 25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kickers. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little closer this time? Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Here's a second and two now from the 33. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
14. Jaguars nothing.
Third down.
The scoreboard tells the story for him. A little bit bleak, and while it's not quite desperation time yet, it's definitely getting close, but the defense reads the scoreboard as well. They're going to back up and make them really earn it.
After the incompletion, here now, third and two. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
They'll throw. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. In the pocket, chucked it away. Flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field. Have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long.
We got three, fellas. We got three.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off. and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw again. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete.
The pass.
It'll be a gain of 17, but even with that, they'll be well short here for fourth down.
I don't know how many times, not just in my playing career, but you and I working together, have we ever heard a coach say, you know, I just don't have that play on my call sheet. That's really what we had here. That was a big hole they were trying to get out of.
Yeah, big gain, still a ways to go, though.
22-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They've really distanced themselves. They have put the pedal to the metal, I guess, so to speak.
So definitely have them in the rearview mirror, don't they? I mean, you're exactly right. Being able to string together these drives that end up in points, it's almost like a run in basketball to create that distance, and they're on a really big-time one right now.
It becomes contagious, doesn't it?
It absolutely does, because oftentimes it translates to your defense as well, because they're excited about getting the ball back for their offense that's playing so well.
Well, they are clicking right now. So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22.
Hey, check Mike 47. Check Mike 47.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Two catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
A deep ball down that right sideline, and he made sure that he put it where either his guy was going to catch it or no one was.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
Watch it. 60 Eagle, 60 Eagle. 79 Bronco.
51's the mic, 51's the mic.
Big loss here as he's taken down. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout. And with that, they're now out of timeouts. There's still plenty of time remaining here in this second quarter. Out of the gun now on third down. He's going deep for Brown. And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Marquise Brown, 79 yards. And the Ravens will extend their lead. So simple math here in the first half. They've had three drives offensively, and they had scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Their own 25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And some dangerous territory. Already down three scores. A three and out here. An inability to put any points. points up, this one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. DJ Chark, the intended target. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. They'll look to throw here. He's got Burton here. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6.
Trey Burton.
A very nice pickup of 33 yards. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. And to give this one to the tailback. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal.
Check 26, check 26.
On second and goal, they'll give it to him again. They follow up the first down 1-yard run with a minimal gain of 2. So now it's third and goal. This Raven defense trying to keep him out of the end zone. Oh, he tried to pitch it, and the ball's loose.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time. Wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
Well, they're going to try this thing. They're at the 5, 4th and goal. They're going to go for it. We'll see run, probably pass two, both in the arsenal. Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. Flushed out right. Open is the tight end, Nick Boyle. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line.
That's good for a Baltimore.
This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
First and 10 at the 23-yard line.
Back to throw now on first down. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 15 more yards there, and quickly another first down.
38-yard line.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. He'll run it. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 27. That late in the clock, second quarter, why not just run it a time or two and get it into the locker room?
What you're saying makes absolutely perfect sense. Run it and get out of there. But I'm just wondering if the pressure of today's NFL and the high-powered offenses that you're facing may force them into saying, let's try and get some more points.
He's going to wind up and air it out. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
On the deep ball, it's second down and 10.
Second and 10 now from the 27. Eluding the pressure right. That one complete. He finds Chark. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. And unless this is a quick incompletion, the This is likely the last play here of this first half. Looking to throw. He's got his tight end, Martin. And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So it's on to halftime of this AFC divisional round matchup as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Winner go home, that's the name of the game, and we're back underway with the second half of this AFC divisional round. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
And we got to get to the ball, team. We got to get to the ball. Let's keep moving. 48. 48's the mic. Target.
He'll look to throw. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Now the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
It's a gain of 8.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, he pulled it in. It's a big play for the Jaguars. 46 yards. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. It was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm hearing my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
Hey, we got 3 down, 3 down.
Now Dobbins. And he's able to get up here to the 26. 7 yards there and a first down.
Second and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
And he's going to have a Ravens first down as the tackle made here at the 36.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack.
The quarterback
hindsight is 20-20, partner. Maybe they should have kept it on the ground again.
Well, it almost looked like the O-line was run blocking again. I mean, they opened up a big hole last time. This time they opened up a hole, and the quarterback got sacked.
We're taking wins home.
On second down, a run with Dobbins. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. 3 yards is the pickup, but it leaves him still needing 11 here on third down.
Well, every now and then we have to let a cliche fly, partner. And in this case, what do they say in the NFL? Your best ability is often your availability. And this is an extremely durable kid coming out of Ohio State. Carried the ball every time they even thought about running it. Wore down defenses and able to break big runs late in games. J.K. Dobbins going to Baltimore, an absolute perfect fit.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third.
That's a 46-yard line.
47, Mike.
Check, smash. Check, smash.
Quit talking about it and bring it.
Hey, check.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Second and 10.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
He's going deep for Brown. And that'll be caught. Touchdown, Ravens. It's Hollywood Brown. Hollywood Marquise Brown. His second touchdown of the afternoon. As the Ravens push further out in front. And he puts it through.
Makes the score. Ravens 28. Jaguars nothing. Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
The Jaguars take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quickly, you should never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And they've got it well across midfield down to the 40 before it's all said and done. 36 yards on the play.
And the Jaguar first down.
So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
Incomplete.
Second and 10 here as we sit in the third quarter of this divisional round matchup.
Pin the mirrors back and go full strength.
Hey, hey, 40's Mike. 40's Mike right there. 40's
into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Picked up by Marlon Humphrey. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to nerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Strong right.
Three down.
finds an opening past the 40. And brought down across the 50 to the 49-yard line. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
You go tight. You got tight. You
70 lying.
Back to throw here. Nice man, complete over the middle. That's Andrews. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
First and 10.
23 yards on the play. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10.
They can't hang with us.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of a running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays. Keep the clock moving, keep them moving.
Yeah, I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Well, they went with a nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down, you bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
And his kick is absolutely perfect. And they're sitting pretty now as the lead grows even further. So it's three more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now following the made field goal, set to kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone, and no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
At the 20.
First play, the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12.
Three. Hey, 80's yours, 80's yours. It's coming this way. Here we go.
Street.
Fake. They'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
When you run in the slant, timing is everything. And against that man coverage, there was no space available. An incompletion as a result.
The Jaguars on third down. 2 for 5 to this point. This is third down and 12. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage. And just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 30. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line.
CD, this defense, man. At this rate, they're just having fun out there right now.
And normally with this type of a lead, if you're a starter on defense, you're saying, hey, let the other guys play. But with this going on, no one wants to come out of the game. They all want their shot at picking off a pass.
Bunch formation. Come on, boys, come on.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble.
Hey, we are.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Flushed out right. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
They are certainly not letting up on the pressure in this one, and oftentimes you hear this expression, all gas, no break from defenses. Okay, break. But in this case, it's the offense still throwing the football
right,
up
right.
Big in the
he's
fourth
tight
quarter.
Right, tight on the right, tight on the right. We got four. We got
and he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Their mobile quarterback saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Ravens turn that interception into a touchdown.
The kick is good.
Tucker with the extra point, and that will extend this big lead.
Jaguars nothing. Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And this carries into the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25.
25-yard line.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a first and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard.
Let's go.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
18 Cardinal.
They'll set up a throw. This one into the hands of Burton. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
It's a game of obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
Okay, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
And 1 yard to go.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back.
And now on fourth and one, it's a fake. And the fake will work. He's going to have a first down. So they get the first down. Maybe not a huge play in terms of yardage, but the fake punt does the job.
49-yard line.
Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Back to throw. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score.
They're running it.
This is caught. I think he got that with one hand. 22 yards there, a first down. We know he has pretty good hands on display there. In fact, he only needed one of them.
Yeah, nowadays, all these receivers work on this, right? They do the one-handed catches off the machine in practice. They do it with their quarterbacks. They do it contested, uncontested. They make it part of their repertoire.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Rolling to his right. Well, I kind of got to give him credit. Another incompletion there, yes, but he's still trying to make plays outside the pocket.
Yeah, he's been hemmed in for much of the game. How about him getting outside there? And that's what you want to see from your quarterback. He's not giving up on this game, so every other player on the field has to say to himself, I can't give up either.
Check 48's the mic.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. A gain there of 21 yards. And that's a touchdown, but hold on. There is a flag down on the field. We'll have to see what this is about. So erase the red zone score. They'll have to dial that one up again.
And you know how difficult it is to strike in the red zone because things are a little bit more condensed. You got to go back to their play chart and see if they can dial up another one.
On play action, they'll throw. Escaping the pressure right. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down.
He's coming. Double up, double up.
Trap 60, trap 60.
Back to throw again. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And oh, it'll be intercepted. It's Chuck Clark picking it off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The utter domination here just continues. This defense, I don't know what more we can say all around about their performance.
It certainly feels in this game like maybe they're facing a Canadian defense. 12 guys on the field. It feels like there's an extra on every snap because they have really struggled to make headway through the air.
It's now second and six at the 24-yard line.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. And they will take a knee here.
Today's final score.
And they have secured a spot in the conference championship. And now you can start to smell it at this point in the season, can't you?
You really can, because the focus has been one game at a time, not looking ahead. But when you get to the conference championship game and you know you're there, the Super Bowl does loom in the future.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The Ravens are victorious here as we say so long from Baltimore.